and they were spray painting about this event. And a liberal activist came up and decided, apparently, to spray him, which is very dangerous.
All right, so now I believe he's back online with us. Jack Bishop, can you hear us?
Yes, sir, I can. Sorry about that.
That's okay. Welcome to WBT, and this is the Pat McCrory Show.
Yes, sir. How are you guys doing?
Doing fine. So what happened?
Well, me and the and some members of a group called Turning Point USA here on campus, it's a conservative organization, we were advertising for an upcoming event that we're having today, actually, with Charlie Kirk, a conservative commentator. And we were in the free expression tunnel where you're allowed to paint anything you want. And we were just painting advertisements out there. We had a Turning Point USA symbol and some conservative slogans. And everything was fine. We spent about 3 hours doing that. One was about 11:30. And about completely out of nowhere, out of the blue, about 2 dozen probably socialists just roll up out of the blue with more spray paint than you can find at Walmart. They proceeded to use intimidation tactics. They were trying to censor us. There was no question about that. This was a pre-planned and concerted effort by them to censor conservative speech on campus. Now, as I was, as we were there, I stood up against the wall to try to protect our advertisement because it's free speech and they aren't supposed to be able to censor us. Most of them spread out across the wall and began to spray over, but I stood my ground, and two people approached me, one gentleman with long black hair, I don't know his name, another female with pink hair, with their two cans of spray paint. Now, they started painting all around me, and, of course, they were drawing at me and whatever, that's neither here nor there, but they were painting all around me. The gentleman with the black hair got my jacket completely ruined. He sprayed the wall and bounced off onto my jacket. This nice leather jacket on me is completely ruined. And then beyond that, obviously one of them, the female, as we were going, she was drawing back and forth at me, and she just leaned right over and just sprayed me in the eye, shot me right in my left eye, and it required an EMS assistance to get it cleaned out. I had to wash it out very thoroughly. And I continued washing it out at his request for the rest of the night.
I'm looking at a picture of that someone took. I'm not sure if someone that was associated with you took it or members of the media took it, where you're leaning against the wall and it shows the woman with two different colors of hair, dressed in white with a backpack and spray paint. Looks like she's about to paint you. What happened to her and who is she?
Well, we don't know who she is or who she is in total. You know what? We do know who she is. I'm not sure the name off the top of my head. I've got it on hand. I could probably find it if I had a man here. But I do know that she is a former board member on one of the leftist clubs here, and she is very, very intimately involved in YDSA, the Young Democratic Socialists of America, a group that regularly tries to intimidate conservatives.
And she is a student?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I believe that she's a senior, I want to say. I might be wrong about that, so don't quote me on that.
So Jack, what did you do? Did you report this to the campus? What's your recourse been?
We called the police immediately. We got the police over there, and they dispersed the crowd. Another gentleman, a tall gentleman, I don't know his name, with some blonde hair, who was also there. He attempted to intimidate some other of our members by ripping posters down and tossing right onto their heads, kind of shoving them around. And they arrested him, but the officers let him go because no one wants to press charges. However, this was an expensive jacket, and my eye hurt for a while, so I'm going to be pressing charges. I'm not going to let them try to intimidate conservative students like this. It's not acceptable.
What about actions by the school? I mean, this young lady is a senior.
Oh, well,
should she be kicked out of school, and should she be allowed to graduate?
Oh, well, I mean, I completely agree with that. Right now, obviously, being investigated by the campus PD because they've obviously got the best connection to her. They can probably find out who she is more easily than anybody else. But I think that if administration were to not find some recourse for this, I think that would be absolutely just unbelievably disappointing. I would think it would be a great blow to the air of free speech that inhabits the school. If a conservative student were attacked and that person received no recourse from the school administration.
Well, regardless of the reason for the attack, that was an assault, and that could hurt you, spraying paint in someone's face. That's spraying poison in your face. And so I concur with you that this person should be taken to court through the court system, and also should be taken to task and probably kicked out of school for a violent act against a student. I don't care if they're conservative or liberal.
Well, I appreciate that, Pat. I think that it's great that you have some level of respect for both sides. It's clear that this group didn't. And by the way, side note, they came with this larger confederation of clubs. It's called No Hate at NC State. And while, of course, they say that they're here to block hate speech and,
right,
and whatever, in reality, they're only purpose is to quash as much conservative thought on campus as they can.
Jack, I lived with these people for 4 years in Raleigh. They were often outside my gates of the temporary home that I had there for 4 years. And first of all, their language is absolutely terrible. But violence has got to be unacceptable on any campus. And on or off the campus, it doesn't make any difference. There are no safe zones where you're allowed to promote violence or enact violence, and I don't care what your political suasion is. So, Jack, be careful out there. You're in a minority on our university campuses, and you're not going to get a lot of support, but right now I think you ought to go to the administration and to the mayor and what are you going to do?
I have every intention to ensure that the administration follows through on this. I'm not in touch with the mayor's office, I'll be honest with you, but I mean, if administration fails me, I most certainly will be. But yeah, absolutely. I'll take you up on that advice. I appreciate that.
Jack Bishop, he is the son of Congressman Dan Bishop.
Which is irrelevant, too.
Well, yeah, but...
But it's an interesting point that this is the son of a U.S. congressman expressing his viewpoints, and he was assaulted.
More thing before we get off of here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. We're having this event with Charlie Kirk tonight, as I mentioned earlier, and I completely forgot to mention this. And we found last night a Antifa logo painted on the Free Expression Tunnel where we had been painting, and word on the street is that Antifa is going to be arriving on mass.
This is the so-called anti-fascist group, which is a very violent group, which was active in the Charlotte riots, too. Thank you very much for being on the show, Jack, and keep us abreast of what's happening on one of our great college campuses in which a very violent faction is expressing their viewpoints, and it must be not tolerated whatsoever.
All right, we are running really late here. Got to hit the news, and we'll be back for hour number two.